morning, First Northeast family. Well, I guess it's not morning yet. It's 11:50 at night, and it's about to be New Year's. And I just want to take a moment to talk with you before the New Year came into play and share a couple of items with you as we enter into 2023. Wow, 2022 is going by so fast and so much has happened. But remember, our vision has changed. We are called to be one family of Jesus followers who bear spiritual fruit so that all people may come to know Christ. And our mission hasn't changed. See, our vision is the destination where we're going, but our mission is how do we get there? We get there by everyone is making disciples. And so for us, it's important that we remember that our mission and our vision make us who we are, and everything we do must align with who we are and where we're going. And so with that being said, at this time, I want to just do a short recap of what we came from last year. Our theme for 2022 has been foundation, fruitfulness, and forward. Foundation, fruitfulness, and forward. And with those three words, we preached through three specific books that covered those three things. One, Ephesians, to be foundational with our doctrine. The first three chapters about who we are in Christ, and the last three chapters, what we do as followers of Christ. And then we did the fruitfulness series with a word along the way where you got to hear different ministers kind of share their heart and devotional thoughts on what it means to be a fruitful follower of Jesus. And then we just finished up the book of James, where he calls all believers, even in the midst of strife and trials and challenges, that we're still called to move forward in our faith in Jesus Christ. And so we're called to make sure that we are doing those things continuously. We had some great wins this year. We had a lot of people come and join, people getting baptized, coming to faith in Christ. We have a lot of new changes, both in facilities and activities and things going on. God is doing some amazing stuff. We've had some changes too. We've had some things that have come and helped us understand what we can do differently and do better. But God is still God, and he is still in charge. Now, what are we going to do now? What does 2023 have in store for us? And I believe that God has in store for us this specifically. The theme for our next year will be the power of praise in the process. What we have to know is that God shows us in John 15, when Jesus is talking about himself being the true vine and his Father being the vine dresser. He tells us there's two options. You either get pruned or you get cut off. Being pruned feels like being cut because you are losing something. But the purpose, Jesus says, is that we may bear more fruit. And so for us, we want to praise God in the process of pruning, and that gives power to our testimony. It gives power to our works, and it proves that the Lord is with us and behind us and going forward and showing us where he's working, that we may join him there. So in next year's three words for us to walk through as we preach through the books of Philippians, 1 John, and Nehemiah, I want you to be actively looking for ways to reconnect. Coming out of the pandemic and us moving forward post-COVID, we need to understand that we need to reconnect in multiple ways. Look for ways to come and gather in person and get to know the new people that have joined and have them meet those who have been here serving faithfully for a while. And so I want you to remember there are going to be great opportunities for you to both serve and to give. And so now I look for your bulletin emails, but look for the announcements at the beginning of worship, and there will be many ways to do that. So be actively looking for those. And someone may approach you directly and ask you to be a part of that. And so we want you to do that. So remember, the three words for next year: joy, love, and focus. And I want to make sure that you understand I'm grateful for each of you. Thank you for walking beside me and my family as I've had to recover and go through much this year and trying to get back and having to settle back down and recover some. It's had its challenges, but I'm thankful for you, First Northeast, for loving me and my family well through this. And so I am so grateful
I just wanted you to hear me publicly say to each of you, thank you. Those that gave, those that served, and those who loved us in this process, it truly means a lot. And it goes known and noticed, and you remain in my prayers of gratitude that the Lord bless you back. And so hopefully as we enter into 2023, we get more opportunities for even us to reconnect and get to know each other more. And look for opportunities for us to be a part of things that are coming. Because there's some activities that are going to take place. I want to see you there. So look for ways to get in and get involved.
Happy New Year, First Northeast family. We love you.
Happy New Year, First Northeast family.
Happy New Year, First Northeast.
Happy New Year, First Northeast family.
Happy New Year, First Northeast family.
With all that being said, I want to take a moment right now as we are entered into 2023. Just to pray, to start off our year, surrendering our hearts, our minds, everything unto the Lord, so that we may follow Him. And so I say to you, as Paul did in 1 Corinthians 11:1, follow me, imitate me, as I imitate Christ. Let's go together to the Lord in prayer. Father in heaven, we thank you right now that you've allowed us to enter into yet another year together. Lord, for us to serve you, to worship you, to learn more about you, to draw closer unto you, and be invited into where you're working, that we may partake in what you're doing where you are, to reach those that you want us to reach for your kingdom and for your glory. Father, I ask for your hand of protection and provision to be with us as First Northeast Baptist Church family, that we all follow you and look to where you're working, and that we may do what you have commanded us to do, to make disciples, to teach them, to baptize them, for us to bear much fruit, for us to love and forgive and show grace and mercy unto one another. And so right now, Father, as we prepare to go into worship just a few hours from now, Lord, we ask that you prepare our hearts in this moment. As we light these candles as beacons of light to represent that we are in your care and in your safety, Lord, I ask that you allow us to be a safe place for others, to come, to connect, to grow, and then to go. Lord, we love you, and we ask this all in Jesus' name, and all of God's children said, amen. God bless you, may he keep you, and Lord willing, I'll see you in worship.